This instructional video will show you how to import a batch of user accounts into the current identity domain. The first thing you'll need to do is create a CSV file that includes the required data for each user account. To create a CSV file, you can use Microsoft Excel, Google Spreadsheet, Notepad, or TextPad. Or it could be output from one of your applications that can export existing user data into a CSV file format. Your CSV file must have this specific format. The first column must be first name, the second column is last name, followed by email, and the fourth column is user login. The user login is the unique name that a user enters when signing in to a service. If you leave the user login field blank, the system will use the value you entered for the email address. So for the sake of time, let's paste in some user information that I created previously. Let me expand this column width for you. As you can see, for some users, I left user login blank, and for other users, I actually specified a value. We'll compare how the system handles that later in this video. The next crucial step is to save your file in the appropriate format. So we are going to do a save as other formats. Enter a name for the file. In the Save As type field, be sure to select CSV and click Save. Okay, so now you have your CSV file saved. Next, you will use the My Services application to import the CSV file. Sign in to My Services application. Be sure to specify the correct identity domain for which you are importing user accounts. Note, you must have the identity domain administrator role to create or import user accounts. After the My Services application opens, select Security to open the security page. Click Import, and then click Browse to locate and select the CSV file that you just edited. Click Import again. A message indicates that your import request has been submitted for processing. When this background job is finished, you will receive an email with the results of the import. Okay, so here is a sample user loading completed email notification that you received from the application. Let's review the email. A total number of 7 records were processed, and of those 7, 6 processed successfully and were uploaded, and 1 failed. And here, it tells you the details of that failure. Jay Fallon at snl.org could not be created because the email address is not valid. Notice that there is a comma here instead of a dot. I did that intentionally to point out how to review for errors. Okay, so now let's return to the security page in the My Services application. In the search field, let's enter SNL as a search criteria, and then click search to find the user accounts we just imported. And here we go. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 records as the email stated. Jimmy Fallon is the one that is missing. You'll notice also that where I entered a value in the user login field in the CSV file, those users have custom usernames. So Tfay, Fletch, and Amy Poe, for instance. Otherwise, the usernames defaulted to the email address given. So at this point, you would go back and fix any errors. Because only one user account was not imported correctly, you would probably use the Add option instead of the Import option to create a single user account. Other than that, you're all set. You have now successfully imported your user accounts to the current identity domain. Okay, so let's review. What have you accomplished so far? You created a CSV file that contained the data for your user accounts and imported the CSV file using the My Services application. You received email confirmation of the import and you reviewed the email for any import errors. Of course, if there are errors, you can either correct the errors in the CSV file and then re-import the file, or you can add the user accounts manually. Your next steps will be to assign roles to your users, and then provide your users with a URL to access your Oracle Cloud service. Users received an email with their sign-in credentials, username, temporary password and identity domain when the user account was created. After you give your users the appropriate URLs, they can sign in, change their temporary password, and begin to use your Oracle Cloud service. For more information, see trial and paid subscriptions for Oracle Cloud services in the documentation library at the following location.